The biggest change between the 2018 Fleet Live Show and Fleet Management Live, apart from the name where we've taken out management to make it far more representative of the market as a whole, I think it revolves around the seminars. In previous years, we just focused purely on the best practice, but this year we're taking much more of a strategic approach with the seminars to really give fleets greater knowledge about the legislation and the taxation changes, and especially the changes in air quality and the clean air zones that will happen over the next few years. They have to plan now for 4, 5, 6, 7 years down the line.
Yeah, one of the things as well that worked well last year that we're splitting more so this year is the seminar sessions. So you've got some sessions that are there for your day-to-day people. Here's how you run a fleet, this is what you do, the operator side of it. But then there's a section that's more on the strategy and the strategic side. So what are the accounting standards doing? You know, that's in now, how's it impacted? How are you funding your fleet with all these clean air zones that are coming in and the impact that's going to have on your business? And what are you doing to protect yourself? So yeah, the strategic stuff going in on change of things, as well as the core operational side of stuff as well.
What's new, I think, about Fleet Live is the content has been designed by the people who are visiting the event. So people like you and me, fleet managers, who need to find out what's going on in the industry, the best products and services, and the best advice as well. The show focuses very, very strongly on advice to visitors. So if you're new to Fleet, or if you're not experienced, you'll find people there who are actually able to help you with the problems that you face on a day-to-day basis.
Yeah, I think now Fleet Management Live, or Fleet Live as we're now rebranded, is much, much more than just the fleet operator. And I think it's really essential that you get buy-in from the top level down. So getting people there from the board, senior people, as I said, from HR, from finance, from operations as well, because it's a much more holistic view of how a fleet impacts a company. And we understand that it's actually the most important part, because you can't run a business without a fleet. And I think people now are starting to look at it much on a much wider basis than just metal and rubber. It's much more about drivers and risk and health and well-being and all the really important things that can get missed if you just focus solely on the vehicle.
For me, Fleet Live is new, it's different, and it's deliberately so. So, because we're trying to do things in a different way, we really break the mould of, I suppose, the old school fleet industry.
Yeah, this year we're going to take it even further than we did last year, so we're going to have a much bigger sort of technology or future fleet zone. So we'll be looking at lots of things around virtual reality training for drivers, which is something very interesting. Looking at more of a blended travel, so it's not just about the vehicle, we're looking at the whole aspects of travel, we'll be looking at drone technology.
It's deliberately not the same as it used to be. We don't want to be like, well, we want to be innovative, we want people to come through and add value, and I think that's the difference.